Hi, my name is Marie-Hélène Hubert, and I'm the collections technician here at the Canadian Museum of Nature. I mostly take care of the fish collection as well as the amphibian and reptile collection. We have around 60,000 jars of fishes in alcohol in 12 different rooms, and we have around 37,000 jars of amphibians and reptiles in 3 different rooms as well. We also have around 2,000 skeletons of fishes and 500 cleared and stained specimens. Here we have a couple of specimens that we can find in our collections. We have, for example, turtle eggs that we can find in this region here in Ottawa. We have also some reptiles that we can find around here as well. We have a bunch of amphibians, and we use this amphibian skin so that we can extract DNA, and then we can do research on this using this instead of the whole frog that has been placed in ethanol for a long time. We also have a process that's called clear and stain, and that allows us to see the skeleton of the fish without the skin and the texture being in the way of it. And finally, we have also fully clean skeletons that help us see the inside of the fish. We do have a couple of interesting specimens in our collections, but the most interesting one to me is the coelacanth. We have 4 coelacanth here at the museum. We have 2 adults and 2 pups, or 2 baby embryos. The coelacanth is a really interesting fish because it was believed to be extinct for 65 million years, and then it reappeared in 1938 next to the coast of South Africa. Some people think that this fish is related or is the missing link to the amphibian and reptiles that came out of the water. It's a misconception. It's actually more related to the lungfishes that we find all around the world. Another one of my favorite specimens here in the collection is just this tiny little cave fish that we have. It's actually also our oldest specimen. It dates from 1863. And slaves from south of the United States sold them to tourists to get money to buy their freedom. This little fish in particular was bought by a British tourist. It eventually made its way to our collection. So in a way, you could say that this fish is actually part of history. These collection rooms are normally closed to the public, but hopefully we see you next year in 2021 to show you everything we have here.